Hi, I'm Jennifer Mack. I'm here at Blue Rock Gallery for my exhibition, All Equine, All the Time. I've been painting horses exclusively since 2002, so it is All Equine, All the Time. That's all I paint. Everywhere I go, what are you painting now? Horses. People are going to see the full gamut of what I'm working on. They're going to see a little bit of new direction from me on the inside, and they're going to see some fun I've been having with paint and colors. I took a trip to Namibia in 2002 and came across a herd of feral horses in the Namib Desert on the Skeleton Coast. I drew and watched and was blown away and decided horses was what I'm going back to. It's all I'm going to do. I grew up with horses. I was always riding. I was always under horses' legs. I would describe horses as spirits. They're just spirits in bodies on the landscape. They're totally raw and totally emotional. The challenge is to bring out the inner life. So I'm trying to paint their insides more than the outside, the soul of it more than anything. When I was a kid, I started painting them pretty small. As soon as I went big, which was right after that trip to Namibia, they were big. They've been big ever since. It's difficult to express what I'm doing small. Big brush marks are important, and it frees up the expression a lot more when I can paint with my whole arm. I try not to paint too much of the horse. I try to leave a lot of the horse out so that it blends with its background, it blends with its atmosphere. It's not separate from everything around it. Often the horse is the negative space. When the horse is the negative space, it subconsciously translates to talking about the soul or the inside of the viewer instead of the body. The contrast in the painting comes from the desert. They were mirages. They were only half there. Black on white, basically. The Namib Desert is crumbling white rock. And the horses were just silhouettes on it. The black and white ones, they're a real challenge. I get one shot. The ink is wet one time. There's no painting over it. There's no covering it up. So if it doesn't work, tear it off and do it again. I prefer to draw still horses, actually. I think the stillness causes the viewer to stop and really look and be still for a moment and see what's going on inside there. Of course, moving horses are so beautiful. How can one not paint them? They're also very expressive. When they're moving, their relationship to the viewer is different. It's a real palpable physical experience. It's a priority in my life because it's what I've been doing all my life, and it just seemed like the most obvious thing to keep doing. Why would I go look for something else when I'm doing my favorite thing already? Normally I just sit in front of that canvas and see what comes up. Sometimes it's easy, and that makes me want it always to be easy. Sometimes it really flows, and that is so much fun. It doesn't always do that. It can be a lot of problem solving. I love being in the zone, but I have got to stop and step back and have a look at what I'm doing because they're big canvases and I can get caught up in the details, and that's not what it's about. It's work as much as it is release of some kind or the fun of creating something. I put all of myself into it and it's work. I'm not perfecting a technical skill of drawing horses. I'm trying to perfect the skill of portraying a feeling on canvas through the horse. The older horses really draw me, the quirky ones draw me, and I draw them. I have a lot of people telling me they can't draw or they're not artistic, and that's really sad because everybody is, but people don't give themselves the room to allow their own creativity to come out. They say, no, that's not good, instead of just watching what they do and seeing what comes out. And that's where original art comes from. It comes from doing it, doing a lot of it so you can see what your style is and then work from there. If people weren't so hard on themselves and so judgmental about their skills, there'd be a lot of original, cool stuff around. Horses have got me. Yeah, I think I have to stay with them because they are a very pure form of expression for me. I'm not at the end of the creative process with these paintings at all. I'll be doing it for a long, long time. Although it's called All Equine, All the Time, these paintings are not necessarily about horses. That is the vehicle I've used to express myself and express various things, trying to use the horse's mass and image to provoke something in the viewer. they're meant to be contemporary and modern and just art that anyone can enjoy. You don't have to be a horse person to enjoy these. Oh, I love Blue Rock Gallery. There's so much here to enjoy, all kinds of arts. I love having my paintings here, sharing the space with ceramicists and sculptors and jewelers. It's just lovely. It's such a supportive environment for art, and I think for art patrons too. So I welcome you to come and see my latest exhibition and give me your thoughts, good and bad, and we'll see you soon.